So today we will start a new topic, is the op amp. We already completed MOSFET and MESFET, right? So today we will start a new topic, is the op amp. So now from today we will do the basics of op amp, the circuitry diagram of the op amp, and the negative feedback, positive feedback, virtual short, virtual ground, this type of topics, okay? Now, what is a op amp? The first question is, what is a op amp? So now I write down, is a op amp, right? Op amps mean operational amplifier. Operational amplifier, okay? That means this device can do the operations and also it can amplify the input voltage, okay? So here, what op amp can do? Op amp can do addition, subtraction, okay, differentiation, integration, log, antilog. So op amp can do all of these things, okay? And also op amp can act as a oscillator also, where in a positive feedback circuit. So I will discuss about the positive feedback later, okay? So op amp is an operational amplifier, so it can do all of these operations, okay? And why it amplifier? As op amp can do the amplification also. Like if you give op amp Vi is 1 volt, okay, then op amp can amplify this voltage and can give you 10 to 15 volt, okay? So we will see the individual thing, the operations as well as the amplifications, okay? So first, this is the symbol of a op amp, okay, where we call it this terminal, we call it a non-inverting terminal. Okay, this terminal we call it a inverting terminal. Okay, this one we call it a positive VSAT, or the positive input voltage we given in the op amp circuit. Okay, this one we call it a negative VSAT, or we can call it a negative voltage we give in the op amp circuit, and this one is the V output. Okay, so this is the circuit with the symbol of the op amp. But when you just went to the shop or in the practical, just they will not give you this symbol, okay? They will give you an IC, right? And that IC will be UA741. This is a op amp IC, okay? This op amp IC consists of 8 input pins, okay? 8 pins, okay? Where you can see the pin 1 is the offset null, pin 1 and 5. What is offset null? I will do a separate video on the offset null, CMRR, slew rate, this kind of topic, okay? That will be in the end stage, okay? Then this point 2 is the pin 2 is the inverting terminal. So this one is the pin 2, okay? This pin 3 is the non-inverting terminal. That means this one is the pin 3. This one is the V minus or minus VSAT. So this is pin 4. So I write down in the separate color, so it will be easy for you. And here 6 is the output, that means this is the 6. 7 is the VSAT plus VSAT, that means this is the 7, okay? And 8 is MC. MC means no connection, okay? So this is the IC of the op amp and the pin configuration, okay? So how a op amp looks like inside this chip? This will be negative, this will be positive, okay? 6, 7 will be plus VSAT, 8 will be, 4 will be minus VSAT, okay? Op amp will be look like this, okay? And for the offset null, what we will do? In the offset null, we use a potentiometer of 1K, okay? There, we use 1, 4 and 5 and adjust that potentiometer to make offset null 0, okay? So I will discuss that, how to adjust offset and what is offset null, Okay, so this is the op amp IC. Now we will see inside this op amp IC the circuit diagram. So this is the circuit diagram. This is the circuit we have in the op amp circuit. So you can see this is a very big circuit, right? And now I think you already covered up the C amplifier circuit, right? Amplifier circuit, the biasing, everything. So you can see here we have many transistors. Okay, so that much transistor make this op amp. Now we will see the simplified circuit of the op amp. So this is the simplified circuit of the op amp. Okay, where this one is the V plus, this one is the V minus. Okay, this one is the RI, this is R zero. Okay, and here we have the load resistance RL. Okay, here we need to take the output voltage V zero. The current will be I zero, output current. Okay, and here we have the Vx. We will see the properties of the op amp. Okay, before that one, from this circuit you can easily understand op amp is a voltage control voltage source, right? Why? As you can see, this is a dependent voltage source, as whose value is AOL multiplied by Vx. That means we can control the value of this voltage source by this Vx value, where Vx is equal to V plus minus V minus. Okay, where I already told you MOSFET is a voltage control current source. Okay, why? As ID is a function of VGS comma VDS. And what is the transistor? Transistor is a current control current source, as IC is equal to beta into IB. That means input current can control the output current. But here op amp is a voltage control voltage source, as input voltage we can control the output voltage. I think it's clear. Now we will see the ideal op amp properties. First, the input resistance of a op amp should be infinite. Okay, this is the first one. Second one will be the output resistance op amp will be zero. Third will be the, this is a voltage amplifier, right? Or this is amplifier. So what we will need? We need the open loop gain should be infinite. Open loop gain means when we don't have any feedback or any load resistance. Okay, so open loop gain will be infinite. Okay, and fourth is the infinite bandwidth. That means this amplifier should work for broader range of frequency, all frequency. Whatever frequency we will use this circuit, the gain will be constant, right? The infinite bandwidth mean what? Is the like this, right? As we all know, what is bandwidth? For this one, the bandwidth is this one, right? That means after F2 frequency and below F1 frequency, the gain will be drop. Okay, so we call it, this one is a bandwidth. In this particular range, the gain will be constant or more than some particular value. Okay, but what we need in our ideal op amp? Ideal op amp should be infinite bandwidth. That means this will be a straight line. Okay, frequency response will be straight line. This will be frequency response of the gain versus frequency. That means this op amp should work all over the frequency from low to high. Okay. Now I will tell you why we need the output resistance should be, why the output resistance should be zero. Let's see. This is the AOL into Vx plus minus, right? If the current is flow through this direction, then this will be plus minus, this will be plus minus, right? This I0 will flow from R0 and RL. So if we use a KVL, then we can write down AOL multiplied by Vx is equal to I0 into R0 plus I0 into RL. Okay, we know that I0 into RL is equal to V0, right? So from here we can write down V0 is equal to AOL into Rx minus I0 into R0. Okay, so now you can see our goal is just to get the V0 maximum, right? But you can see here V0 is the addition of AOL into, sorry, is the Vx, AOL into Vx minus I0 into R0, right? That means if this resistance is positive, then this will be decreases the V0. Okay, so what we need to do? This term should be zero, right? That means we need to do either output current should be zero or output resistance should be zero. Okay, if output current is zero, then output current I0 is zero, then V0 also will be zero, as V0 is nothing but the voltage drop across the load resistance. Okay, so that means we cannot make output current zero. So what we can do? We need to do the R0 should be zero. Okay, this is true for all of the voltage amplifier. Okay, so what we need to do? R0 should be zero. Okay, that's why the output resistance is zero. Okay, then why the input resistance is infinite? As when you give a voltage source here, okay, if this resistance is not infinite, then what will happen? There will be some current flow. Okay, and if this current will flow, is if this resistance is low, then the current will be much higher. Okay, what we don't need in a voltage amplifier. So what we need, and this will be resistance, right? So this will be heated up. Okay, so that's why there will be some loss. So we don't need that much loss. So what we need to do? We need to do RI should be infinite, as we don't need the current, we need the voltage. So if this resistance is infinite, then also we will get total voltage. Okay, and suppose the voltage source have some, suppose this voltage source have some resistance. Just consider, we give a voltage source and this voltage source have some resistance, internal resistance, right? Then what we will do? If we have a resistance here, that means one current, some current will flow, and this current will give some drop across this resistance. The lower the resistance, higher the current. Higher the current, the higher the voltage drop. And higher the voltage drop in this resistance, lower the voltage we get across this point A and point B. Okay, that's why what we need to do, we need to make input resistance infinite such that there will be no input current. If no input current, then there will be no loss. Okay, so this is the very basics of the op amp, the properties of the op amp, and the symbol and the IC. Okay, so I think I want to explain all of this topic. In my next video, I will explain you the what is the virtual short or the virtual ground. Okay, where I will explain you about the open loop gain is what. Okay, and I will calculate the V0. Okay, so that's all from this video. Thanks for joining. Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you for watching my video, and share this concept with your friend, and like and subscribe my YouTube.